come on.
Mike, where are you?
I'm right here. I'm going upstairs. Where are you? Come on, I hear you downstairs.
In the summer of 1999, I stepped foot into my local cinema and for the next 82 minutes experienced what is still to this day one of the most frightening films I've ever seen, The Blair Witch Project. The film follows three college students as they shoot a documentary about a witch that has been said to haunt the woods around a small town in Maryland. The students disappear in the woods and a year later their footage is found, stitched together and presented as the Blair Witch Project. During the lead up to the film's release, the directors relied on a viral marketing strategy which propagated the myth that the story told in the film was actually real and that the film was a documentary. Soon, blogging sites were flooded with conversations surrounding the authenticity of the upcoming release. Was this really found footage? Were these people really dead? Is this all real or just a scam? The hype was real. Though the marketing campaign was ultimately the calling card for its initial success, it's the film's ability to induce fear through anticipation, fear of the unknown, the unseen, that makes it such an effective horror film. Throughout the entire film, we are never shown the witch. Instead, the audience is encouraged early on, during the interview with the local townspeople, to subconsciously begin to build their own imagery of the malevolent presence.
Yeah, it's a story my grandmother used to tell us all. Make us go to bed early.
Really?
Say if you stay up after dark or walk around the house too much, a Blair Witch would come and get you.
I was laying down on the leaves, a pile of leaves, kind of watching my phone and looking up at the sky.
Sure.
And all of a sudden I felt like something was near me.
Right.
You know, kind of a eerie feeling. It was like a woman, only on her arm and on her hands and everything. It was like hair, like a real dark, almost black hair.
Uh-huh.
Like a horse.
Like a fur?
Yeah, like a fur, like horse fur. Then her arm, she had like a shawl.
Right.
Wool shawl over her.
And she scared you? She threatened
and,
you?
And she didn't say anything, but she just kept staring, and then
right.
She opened up her shawl.
And what was under there?
And under it, there was hair on her body, like a
so
horse.
She was hairy from head to toe?
Yeah, it's and her legs, and her, you could see
right. How about
she was
her face?
Female. It's just kind of like strange.
In allowing the audience to let their imaginations run wild, it helps develop a much more visceral internal fear. In good horror, it's not what we see, but what we don't see. The Blair Witch Project stands as a testament to show just how effective low-budget amateur filmmaking can be. With a budget of $60,000 and gross earnings of over $250 million, it's a pretty exciting and inspiring prospect for any amateur filmmaker.